secret. And it ain't just something small. Today, I'm gonna show you how to make this knife. Chop like this.
With just some basic macrame knots!
Hey, Patreon! Whoa!
This is one of the last, maybe this is the last week that you can win.
Click the link in the description and you can win these lives. Yeah.
Crazy.
So, this is the most requested video on this bloody channel. You won't believe it?
No.
But there are two big reasons we have not made a video about this yet.
One.
We kind of forgot how to do it. So, what we're talking about is this little thingy on the knife.
Like the lanyard combined with the paracord bracelet.
It gives your knife much more leverage, much more chopping power. Like, it's not just a little bit, it's like maybe 200% more chopping power, maybe even more.
Yeah.
So the second reason we never made this video.
Second.
Because we thought it would be goddamn boring.
Yeah.
So this was a challenge for us to make a video about this. Still make it interesting, because we are now going to show you how, with just a little tool like this, you can make literally every knife with a lanyard hole better. Every knife, eh?
It's a DIY. It's a life hack. It is popular on the internet.
Hey!
Martin!
Yo.
We're at the chopping wood
chopping station.
Okay, first we're going to do a chop without
Aurora.
Hello.
Oh wow, it is so comfortable because it has like a bracelet and doesn't itch on my wrist. It is so nice. I want a fat. Like literally, with this, I don't really even need to hold the knife that tight because it will. Like this, it will already be safe. You don't
hey,
want to do that.
And you really want to hold it tightly because I look.
And it was without a lanyard.
No, that was with. Only I was holding my hand a little too close to the place of chopping.
Nice.
Let's begin. Grab about 180 centimeters of rope and you put it through your knife and fold it. Step two is that you make sure that it is asymmetrical because there's gonna be a loop. About one third of a difference. Step three, put the long end over the short end. Put it through the loop. Then you put it over itself. Then you go behind and pull it through the loop. Yeah, through the hole. Step four is that you're gonna adjust the loop or the length of the lanyard bracelet to the right size. So you're gonna grab the back of the knife and put your hand through the loop and then adjust it with the adjustable knot to the length you want. And you want it to be tight on the hand when you
Step five!
You're gonna make the loop as long as you want the bracelet macrame thing, you know. Step six! Step six is that you're gonna turn the loop so that you have the loop falling down. Then you have a rope left and right that you can do the whole magic. Hey. Step seven is now we're gonna divide it into two segments. The bulge side and the non-bulge side. Yeah? Cheeky. Step eight is we're gonna perform a square knot. The bulge side every time is gonna go over the bracelet, and the non-board side is gonna go over the thing, over the rope that you have just put over the bracelet. You go behind the bracelet, and then you're gonna put that through the loop on the board side. Now you have created a nice little bulge on the other side of the bracelet.
Bulge.
You're gonna repeat this, Steph. Till you keep a little bit of your loop. Just a tiny bit that you only can
you're
just about
this,
fit your
then
rope
you
through.
Force this into this loop. And then you gotta force this.
Then the bulge side goes through it. And you just repeat that the whole square knot thingy. You're gonna repeat this whole thing one more time on just a single piece of rope. Then cut the pieces of cord and melt them a little bit. Press them. Yeah. That is it. Oh, I hate this video.
Manly!
Ooh.
Bushcraft Boy!
Bushcraft Boy!
A.K.A. Witty Man!
That's racist. Well,
ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say, look out, please. There are a few things you need to look out for.
Our Patreon.
Well,
last week that you can win. CRC, Mil Cowrie, crazy.
And a Valkdieven A1 and an F1X.
That's crazy. That is one big military giveaway. That is crazy. And that is that you're rich. If you win, you're rich.
Yeah.
Nice.
More than €1,000, yeah? Yeah,
okay.
Way more than $1,000. Listen, there are a few things to look out for. First thing, you gotta have quality paracord because you don't want this thing slipping out in your hand if you're not holding it right.
Preferably mil-spec 3 paracord.
Yeah.
That is military standard and it has 7 strands.
Hey, and another thing is when you're chopping like this, don't hold your hand very close.
What happened?
Because I have experienced the Valkdieven A1 slip right into my hand.
Oh.
Yeah.
And you stole the A1 and then you bought it back.
Yeah, and it was because of this, because it's not that stable and it will slip sometimes, so hold your hand somewhere far
you
away.
Can really exert a lot of power on your knife using this, because you can grip your knife at the outmost back part. It gives a lot of leverage. It's crazy.
Hey.
I've seen trees fall with one swing.
One swing.
Trees like this.
And this is just a little lesson from DBK, yo. Hey, please visit our shop. Strops, Compound, DC Force, DBK DC Force. Hey, watch us every Thursday, 1 p.m. PDT, and subscribe.
Yeah.
And the like you like.
Consider checking out the Instagram because there are so many funny pictures over there.
Bye.
Bye.